welcome back. I know a lot of you on YouTube and subscribers and whatever love Japanese RPGs. So I was, you know, thinking, what the heck, I'm going to do a Japanese RPG collection. It's kind of funny because I actually thought I have more than this. But okay, I won't be talking a lot about this, just showing which I got and if it's good or not. We start with the PlayStation and it's Blaze and Blaze, pretty good. Blood Fry 3, again pretty good. Final Fantasy 7, amazing of course. Whoops. Alundra, I haven't played that much. Final Fantasy 8, amazing. Grandia, I haven't played it yet, it's sealed. Final Fantasy 6, I got it only for the Final Fantasy 10 demo. Final Fantasy 9, of course, amazing. So I don't have that big amount of PlayStation 1 games, so I have to try and get more. On PS3, I got Cross Edge, pretty nice. Folklore, also pretty nice. Star Ocean, really great game. Final Chronicles, again an incredible game. Final Fantasy 13, one of the biggest disappointments of this generation, but it's pretty good. Egg of the War, sucks. Skyrim 3, amazing. 3. Game Heroes, again amazing, but you have to love the art style. PlayStation 2, I have Rogue Galaxy, amazing of course. Legia 2, just played it yet, well, recently played it. Final Fantasy 10, amazing. Final Fantasy 12, here is where the disappointment began, because even though the art style was cool and the story was okay, the battle system sucked monkey ass. Kingdom Hearts 1, amazing. Kingdom Hearts 2, I haven't played it that much, but it's pretty good. Persona 3, only got this because of supporting of the developers. Persona 4, amazing. Dark Cloud 1, really good. Dark Chronicles of Dark Cloud 2, amazing. Dragon Quest, again amazing, but it's really, really hard. This guy, Hour of Darkness, really good and fun action RPG, strategy RPG, with an amazing amount of content. Odin, so I haven't played it that much, but it looks beautiful. Final Fantasy X2, really good, but for me, too girly. Utterly Heroes 2, amazing. Breath of Fire, Dragon Quarter, sucks ass. Shin Megami Tensei, Digital Devil Summoner, Devil Saga 2, really good, even though it's again really hard. Shin Megami Tensei Devil Summoner 1 sucks. Xenon Saga 2, haven't played it yet. Ark of the Lad, haven't played it yet. Showdown of Government, it's okay. And Suikoden 4, haven't played it yet. Those were my PlayStation 2 RPGs. Oops. For the PSP, Valhalla Knights 2, it's okay. Breath of Fire 3, only got this because I'm a huge fan of Breath of Fire 3. Valkyria Profile Lenneth, haven't played it that much, but I didn't like it. Astonia Story, haven't played it yet. Dragon's Aria, haven't played it yet. Skyrim, Afternoon of Darkness, haven't played it, but it's, you know, it's just a remake of the Gaia 1 with a few extra content. The Legend of Heroes, Tear of Vermilion, pretty good. Tales of Eternia, pretty good. Tales of the World, Radiant Mythology 1, pretty good. Popo Locros, sucks. Crimson Gem Saga, the best Japanese RPG or Korean RPG on the PSP for me. Crisis Core, Final Fantasy, the best Japanese RPG, action RPG maybe, on a PSP, a really good game. Final Fantasy, great of course. Final Fantasy 2, great of course. And Final Fantasy Tactics, the War of the Lions, too slow paced for me. So those are my RPG collection. Of course I got a lot of, you know, games like Dragonar that has this RPG style, but it's just an action game, and of course Demon's Souls, I do have that, but it's more like a Western RPG, even though it is made in Japan. So I hope you love this collection video, and see you next time.